There's a guy running for city council this year, mid-30s, born and raised in Northwest Ohio, independent candidate Mike Ferner. He's been out walking the neighborhoods of Toledo just about every night for the last 4 or 5 months, finding out what people are thinking about. Door to door, shaking thousands of hands. And he found out that people are concerned about basically the same things. Good jobs, better housing, a clean environment, low utility rates. Same thing that Mike Ferner's been thinking about for 10 or 15 years. He's been walking, talking, listening, attracting hundreds of volunteers to his campaign. And these volunteers have come up with some interesting ideas on their own, things like a human billboard, taking Mike's message directly to the streets of Toledo. One by one, and in small groups, Mike's been talking and listening, asking questions, getting the same answers again and again, just getting ready to become a member of Toledo City Council. This tape will let you hear a couple of Mike's comments on various issues, plus comments of other people talking about Mike. One thing, though, before we begin, a note that Mike faces very serious competition in this race for City Council.
We've got a lot of council candidates now that seem to have full-time jobs and go to council on Tuesday and vote, and then you never hear from them again. Mike's out in the streets. He talks to people. You know, he's out talking, and he's got real experience, I think, with the grassroots work in politics, and I think a lot of people respect that. And he knows people. You know, he really knows how to respond to people, and he's been out talking to people for a long time.
I'm for Mike Ferner for City Council because I think that Mike cares about Toledo and about the important issues facing Toledo, and that he can make a difference here. I'm concerned about the environment, which is one of my major concerns.
Last year, Toledo City Council had a wonderful opportunity. They had the ability to join a half a dozen other local governments in Northwest Ohio that had passed a resolution telling the state they did not want the EnviroSafe toxic waste dump expanded, and our city council sat on their hands and let that opportunity go by. That's something that we cannot afford to have happen in the city of Toledo. That's something that I'm going to be speaking out on from this day all the way through the election, and after I'm on city council, that issue is not going to be allowed to die in Toledo City Council.
The reason I stand with Mike Ferner is because he's a man you can depend on, a man that you can trust. I'm tired of politicians that promise one thing and do something else. Mike is a man that whatever he says, you could depend on. And now it's time to have a change in city council, a change that's for the better of the people. Therefore, I say vote yes for Mike Ferner.
I first started working for Mike in his last campaign, and I had known Mike actually before he started running for city council, and knew him because of the support he gave to the farm workers. I work for Farm Labor Organizing Committee, and whenever we asked Mike to come out, he would come out and support us, and every person's support at that time was important. So I knew Mike because of the support he was able to give before, so I know he's genuine. I know he cares about people because he's a union organizer, and that demands a lot of work, and he was willing to give that not only for us, but in his own work as a union person. So I trust him that if I came to him with a problem from the community, he would respond, he would listen. And that's what started me working for Mike. And then as I've listened to him more and learned more of his concerns of the environment, of communities, of where money should be spent from the city, it's just increased my confidence in him that he would really be a responsive council person listening to the needs of the community. And we certainly need that in Toledo.
We have right across the street the Summit Center office building that sits three floors empty. the city of Toledo put more money by millions of dollars, more of our tax money went to buy the land and provide a parking garage for the Summit Center than we have ever spent in the history of the city of Toledo in rehabilitating homes and providing a decent place for people to live. That's the first priority that needs to be arranged in this city. We spent enough money buying cornfields in Montcalm Township that we could have gotten over 1,000 homes rehabilitated right now in the city of Toledo and have people living in them, paying taxes on homes that were occupied instead of having vacant and abandoned homes, contributing to problems of drugs and crime and being a blight on the neighborhoods. And we have several beautiful air-conditioned skywalks that are supposed to provide foot transportation for the thousands of tourists who are going to come to Toledo when we have thousands of Toledoans right now with no place to sleep at night, no roof over their head. We have some beautiful air-conditioned skywalks. That, fellow citizens, are upside-down priorities.
Saludos, amigos. My name is Ramon Perez, and I'm here to talk to you about Mike Ferner's campaign. Mike Ferner's campaign has been working very hard, and we need to get involved. There's a lot of work that needs to be done yet. We need you to come and volunteer some time to help Mike Ferner's campaign a successful one. Mike Ferner has been involved and committed to the Latino community here in Toledo, Lucas County area. As I said, we have a lot of work that needs to be done, and we need you to come out and show your support by volunteering and by voting on November the 7th. Amigos, we have to support Mike Ferner. Es un hombre con dignidad y respeto. Gracias.
We need to have the city get serious if we're talking about trying to avoid the costs, political and economic, of having to find another landfill someplace. Everybody gives lip service to recycling, but I have not heard one peep come out of anybody in city government to talk about how we're going to actually implement a program of recycling and make that a serious part of how the city deals with solid waste.
This is someone who has been fighting environmental issues and actively working on them from the heart for years. This is someone who really is not a politician. This is an activist who now has found that maybe the best thing he can do to further his efforts in the movement is to run for office. The idea is to have an activist be elected. And that's really that's an idea that is really rare, I suppose, in a lot of cities, and especially in Toledo.
We're coming down to the last few days in the campaign. We've been hard at it since summer and all through the fall, and a lot of dedicated volunteers have been spending their time and lending their talents and contributing their money to get the message out that there is opportunity for the city of Toledo to have an independent voice on city council for a change. A voice that's not going to be afraid to stand up to the utility companies, to stand up to the special interests in town, and make sure that the public's interest is spoken about clearly when it needs to be on Toledo City Council. I'd like to warmly invite any of you to get involved in the last few days. Your effort right now can make a big difference. We've been working at it very hard, and I think the last few days here is going to make the difference, and you can be a part of that. If you have an interest in volunteering your time or making a financial contribution, I'll tell you right now, we can put it to good use, and you would be welcome to be a part of the last couple of days as we get down to the November 7th election. Thank you very much, and remember to vote Tuesday, November 7th. Thank you.